Heavenly Father, we gather in your presence with hearts open to receive your word. As we reflect on the Gospel of Mark, chapters 2, verse 23 through chapter 3, verse 6, we seek your wisdom and understanding. Guide us through the scripture and help us to see your truth and apply it in our lives. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. One Sabbath, Jesus was going through the grain fields, and as his disciples walked along, they began to pick some heads of grain. 24 The Pharisees said to him, "Look, why are they doing what is unlawful on the Sabbath?" He answered, "Have you never read what David did when he and his companions were hungry and in need?" 26 In the days of Abiathar the high priest, he entered the house of God and ate the consecrated bread, which is lawful only for priests to eat. And he also gave some to his companions. Then he said to them, "The Sabbath was made for man, not man for the Sabbath." 28 So the Son of Man is Lord even of the Sabbath. Another time Jesus went into the synagogue, and a man with a shriveled hand was there. Two, some of them were looking for a reason to accuse Jesus, so they watched him closely to see if he would heal him on the Sabbath. 3 Jesus said to the man with the shriveled hand, "Stand up in front of everyone." Then Jesus asked them, "Which is lawful on the Sabbath, to do good or to do evil, to save life or to kill?" But they remained silent. He looked around at them in anger and, deeply distressed at their stubborn hearts, said to the man, "Stretch out your hand." He stretched it out, and his hand was completely restored. 6 Then the Pharisees went out and began to plot with the Herodians how they might kill Jesus. In these passages, we see Jesus challenging the Pharisees' rigid interpretation of the Sabbath laws. He emphasizes that the Sabbath was made for the benefit of people and not as a burden. By healing on the Sabbath, Jesus demonstrates that doing good and saving life should always take precedence over legalistic observance. His actions and teachings call us to prioritize compassion, mercy, and the true intent of God's laws. We offer this prayer in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen.